and welcome to another episode of Mindset to Mastery, the podcast. I'm your host, Keisha A. Rivers, President and Chief Outcome Facilitator of the CARS Group, where we facilitate outcomes by equipping people to embrace and manage change. On this podcast, my main purpose, my main goal is to provide you with information and insights and great conversations that will make you think differently and essentially change your mindset so that you can master your success. And there was something that hit me earlier today that I have noticed as a trend on social media, on podcasts, on all the different requests that I've been getting for to facilitate conversations about racism and privilege and diversity, equity, and inclusion efforts. And I've been asked over and over and over again to present, quote unquote, to produce content, quote unquote. To instruct, quote unquote. And I want to talk today about, let's skip the content and instead let's connect. If you want to create an environment that is conducive to change in your organization, if you want to create an environment that is conducive to people showing up fully and wholly and authentically, if you want to create an environment that is conducive to everyone contributing and leading from within, if you want to produce and create and cultivate an environment where people feel safe sharing and people feel safe being themselves and people feel valued and they want to bring their whole selves to work and be engaged and committed, then let's just skip the content. Let's skip the workshops. Let's skip the trainings. Let's skip all of the plans that are constantly bombarding people with this whole notion of this is what you do and this is how you do it and this is what's wrong with you, what you're doing and how you're doing it and who you are and this is what's right, and cramming all of that into their heads and down their throats. One thing I have noticed is that a lot of people, myself included, we're on overload when it comes to all of this content. We're never going to get around to really digesting it, to really, doing a deep dive into it. We're never going to feel as if we have enough time to really understand it. And none of these models are creating an opportunity for us to be able to engage with it. And yeah, I know you're thinking to yourself, hey, I'm listening to a podcast. Isn't this content? Well, yes and no, because I'm sharing my frustration with you. I'm sharing my thoughts with you. I'm sharing my experience with you. I am sharing my personality and my perspective and who I am as a person, as well as a consultant and business owner. I'm sharing who I am. And in the process of sharing who I am while I share information with you, I'm building an opportunity for us to connect. No, you don't have an opportunity to talk to me right now while I'm recording this. But you can talk to me about it by email. You can talk to me about it by sending me a message on my website. You can talk to me by commenting on it on social media or on my platforms where it is being broadcast. We have to get out of this mode of being passive receptacles, empty vessels that are waiting to be filled. We have to get out of this mode of feeling as if we are constantly bombarded with all of this information that our brains and our minds don't have time to process and really don't have time to take in and absorb. You cannot move the needle on achieving outcomes or achieving goals or creating a path to success if you do not allow yourself to just sit and pause and process what it is that you're receiving. You can't move forward. You can't become better. You can't improve if you are not going to connect with the information and the insights and the perspectives that you are being given. Let's move away from content and let's focus on connecting with each other, connecting with the information, connecting with our experience, and connecting with where we are right now and where we're trying to go. So what does that look like? For example, I have been facilitating, and I call it facilitating instead of training, I have been facilitating a number of conversations about racism, privilege, Black Lives Matter, diversity, equity, inclusion, change processes, and how to manage chaos, a number of different topics that are usually very, very, very intense. They cause a lot of emotional upheaval. They cause a huge emotional reaction. They require people to step out of their comfort zones and to be incredibly uncomfortable with the topic as well as the process. But if I'm hammering this at you for an hour or 90 minutes or a half day, and I never give you an opportunity to talk about it, I never give you an opportunity to just sit and reflect on it, I never give you an opportunity to say, this is really what I think about it, I never give you the opportunity to listen to other people's perspectives, other people's thoughts, other people's ways of thinking, other people's ways of how they're going to implement it. If I don't give you an opportunity to do something with this and be active with it, then you're not really getting anything out of it. So let me give you a hint. Let me give you a tip. Let me give you a huge aha moment that I have come to the realization of when it comes to the way in which we share information. You cannot learn, you cannot grow, you cannot become better at all, at anything, unless you have time to truly sit with the information and to connect with it as well as with others. We do not learn in a vacuum. We are not people or creatures that want isolation. If anything, the reaction that people have had to COVID-19, the pandemic, and the stay-at-home orders and the directives that people have given them in terms of how they have to quote-unquote isolate, that should tell you people are not, they don't exist on an island. They're social creatures. And the way we make meaning of the world is to connect with others. The way we make meaning for ourselves is to have something about us or our past experience that we connect with to that comes out in the content, in the information. If there is no connection, if there is no experience, if there is no aha moment, then there is no learning. And if there is no learning, there is no growth. And if there is no growth, there is no change. And if there is no change, then we're stuck doing the same old things over and over and over again. You have to give yourself time to connect. And that is with the information. So, case in point, if I am participating in, several intensive trainings, and all it is me sitting there for 90 minutes to 2 hours to however long the seminar is or however long the virtual conference or the symposium or whatever it is, if I'm just sitting there and I'm listening and I'm watching a slide presentation or I see the speaker who's talking and I don't do anything at all, I don't participate in the chat, I don't answer a poll, I don't write down my thoughts, I don't talk to anybody else, if I'm just sitting there, sooner or later, my mind starts to wander. As interesting as it is, as much as I want to learn this information, my mind starts to wander. I start thinking about all the other things I need to do. There are distractions around me, even though I tried to close myself off into a quiet space. I'm not engaging with this, so I'm not really catching all of it. And the longer it goes on without you getting a break and actually doing something to connect with that information, the less likely it is that I'm going to walk away with tangible, actionable steps that I can apply. So when you listen to podcasts like mine, And I tell you, I want you to stop for a minute and think about this. I want you to connect with the information that I'm giving you. I want you to reflect on when there was a time when you felt the same way. I want you to write down what are the next three things that you're going to do. I want you to think about the situation that you're facing at home and at work and personally, and how does this apply to your life? Let's skip the content. Start connecting the information that you are listening to and that you are being exposed to with who you are and what you want and what your goals are and what you're willing to do and your experiences. Make it personal. In this age of a global pandemic and civil unrest due to a spotlight being shown on systemic racism and microaggressions and discrimination and ways in which we are not all treated equally, you can't just go in with a sledgehammer or a fire hose and say, this is what you need to change. Here's all of the ways that you are wrong. Here are 10 steps of things that you need to implement right now. That doesn't work. You need to connect. You need to have a way of feeling, you have to feel some kind of way about what you're hearing. You need to have conversations with yourself about what you are reading and being exposed to. You need to feel what it is that you are learning. So that's one, connecting to the information, making it personal, making it about you, and how does this make me feel, and what do I think about it, and how can I connect this, and what is it about what I already know that makes this make sense, and how am I going to implement this moving forward? Connect with the information. Number two, you need to connect with other people. We don't learn by ourselves. As much as an introvert as I am, I still need to talk my thoughts out with other people. I still crave the interaction and the conversations with other people. Because your perspective may be slightly different from mine. And even if we share the same view, the way you got to your conclusion is going to be different than the way I got to mine because we think differently. We process things differently. And the art of metacognition, which is thinking about thinking, when you start thinking about the way that you're thinking and why you're thinking that way and how you came to these conclusions and what steps you took and what you connected, you're going to be so much better because now you're digging deep. When you connect with other people, you are allowing yourself the opportunity to learn from and to contribute to another person's growth. You are making this social, which, as I said, people are social beings. We learn from each other. We connect to each other. We go bonkers when we're left entirely alone and isolated. So connecting with other people and having a dialogue, even if you don't agree. Because let me let you in on a secret. You do not have to agree with everyone in order to learn from them. You don't have to think that their conclusions are spot on. You can think they're completely wrong and completely off. But having a conversation with them and really connecting and finding out the reasons, what is it that make you say that? What is it that causes you to believe that? What experiences have you had that have led you to this point? If I don't understand your perspective and I don't understand your perception and the ways in which the world around you impacts your decision-making and your actions, then I'm not really open to learning and growing, and I'm also not open to connecting and working collaboratively with you. So many times I've seen it in organizations over and over and over again. They don't want people talking about what's going on. They won't want people talking about the learning process. They don't want people sharing their experiences. It's, oh, we don't have time for stories. What does that have to do with what we're learning or what we're doing? Stories are our ways of connecting with each other. Stories are our ways of providing context for the experience. Stories are our ways of looking at information in new ways. Stories and having conversations with people is a way for us to open up and expand the way that we think, the way that we perceive, the actions that we think are possible. If the only way that you approach life is based on what you already know, then you're going to create the same types of results because you're taking the same types of actions. There's a saying, if the only tool you have is a hammer, everything looks like a nail. But if you have wrenches and screwdrivers and saws and tape measures and all of these other things in your toolbox, then you're going to approach different issues, different situations differently because you have more tools in your box. Connecting with other people adds more tools to our boxes. It enables us to learn vicariously by having conversations with other people. We don't have to go through that experience because I listened to this person, I connected with their story, I connected with them, I had a conversation where I was open to their perspective and their perceptions and their experiences, and now, I don't have to necessarily do that because I remembered what happened with this person. And once again, you do not have to agree. You do not have to share the same exact conclusion. You do not have to come from the same exact belief system in order to learn from other people. We just have to be respectful in our dialogue. We have to be respectful in our conversation. There is no reason why two completely capable, mature adults cannot have a conversation about something they disagree on and have to resort to name calling and being rude and disrespectful and physical altercations. You're better than that. Yes, and if things get heated because you get emotional, then you're passionate about it and learn to step away. So one, you need to connect with the information, make it relevant, make it real. Two, you need to connect with the person, with each other. We need to have a village or people that we communicate with so that we can help us to process the information and the experience and learn vicariously through other people's perspectives. And number three, we need to connect with ourselves. We need to understand, what is it about this information that is relevant to me? What is it about this situation that is important? What is it about this information that can apply to who I am and what I want to do and where I'm going? How do I feel about this? What do I think about this? If I really reflect, how is this alike or is this different from what I've experienced before? How is this challenging what I think I know about myself? Is my reaction or my response to this or to the person that's talking about this, what is this saying about me? And let me take it a step further, especially when it comes to things that make you react emotionally to immediately try to dismiss it as not being true or not being relevant based on on a set of facts that you hold. If it's something that causes you to immediately reject it emotionally, that is exactly what you need to delve deeper into. Those are the things you need to reflect upon. Those are the things that you need to understand and say, you know what? I need to look at myself. What is it about me that's making me act this way? This is especially true when you're having any type of difficult conversation around race or discrimination or politics rights, human rights, anything that tends to poke at something that you have held to be a long-standing belief or value system requires you to reflect. It requires you to think about, what is it about this situation and why do I feel this way? What is it about this that's making me have this negative reaction? What is it about this that is pricking me? Because if something is pricking you to the point where you get emotional and passionate, then it's something to be examined. Not saying that it's something you're going to change, but you have to understand yourself to understand the reasons why you react and you respond the way you do. Because the way that you think, the way that you process, directly informs and impacts and influences the actions that you take. And if you do not connect with yourself to really understand why and what is it about this that is making you feel this way, think this way, act this way, speak this way, if you don't understand the why, if you don't understand the cause, if you don't understand the root in terms of what it is about this new bit of information that is causing this reaction, then you're not going to be open to growth. You're not going to be open to change. You're not going to be open to going through the process. As I've said over and over and over again, change is a process that begins with an event. You start with the catalyst, that's the event. You go through the shift of transformation. And during that shift of transformation, you have to connect with the information. You have to connect with other people. You have to connect with yourself. It's not just about the content. It's about what you think about the content. It's about what you believe about the content. It's the ways in which you connect. It's the ways in which you share beliefs or information or insights with other people. It's the ways in which you understand fully and deeply who you are and what is it about you that causes you to do whatever it is you do. That's all wrapped up in the shift of transformation. And then all of those things assist you in being able to create your next normal, your application. As a result of what I've taken in, as a result of the connections that I've made, as a result of the reflections that I've done, as a result of the internal work and the conversations that I've held, this is the next normal. This is now what I'm going to do. This is how I'm going to apply it. This is how this is going to show up. So, based on this event of listening to this podcast, I want you to do the deep work of transformation. I want you to think more deeply about the ways in which you connect with information, ways in which you connect with other people through conversation and perspective, sharing perspectives and experiences, and ways you connect with yourself in terms of being reflective and really, really understanding, what is it about me that makes me say this? What is it about me that makes me think this? What is it about me that makes me act in this way? Let's skip the content. It's not about how many facts you can repeat. It's not about how eloquent you are in talking at people and giving a speech. It's about how well do we connect with the other person, with the person in front of us, with the people around us, with the people who are important to this process. How do we connect with the world around us? I did a post on LinkedIn that said I was tired of creating content. I was fed up with the whole notion of everybody talking at once, just sharing their thing that they wanted to talk about without any regard or any opening or any welcoming of conversation or input from other people. We have gotten into this habit because of social media where we to engage has been reduced to clicking an emoji. We click the emoji, we keep it moving. Hey, I gave you a heart emoji, that meant I loved it. Hey, I gave you a thumbs up, that meant I liked it. Hey, I put an angry face or a sad face. I was angry, that upset me, or I was sad. But no commentary. No conversation. True connection means there's a conversation. There's a conversation within you. There's a conversation in terms of, you know, talking out what you're thinking. There's a conversation with other people, but there's a conversation. Use your words. Not only to spew venom people who have a who disagree strongly, oh, they got tons to say. They're writing long form essays and manifestos in the comments. But what about just saying, I agree? Or yes, I had a similar experience because, or you know what, that was really insightful. I need to think about that and process that a bit. Let's start connecting. Let's start using our words. Let's start being critical thinkers. Let's start diving more deeply into the reasons behind our thinking. Let's start reflecting. Let's start connecting. Move away from content. Move away from speaking at people. Move away from just seeing things on the surface and not really letting it marinate within you. Let's move away from feeling as if we're operating in a vacuum. Yes, I know you may not be able to talk to people face to face or hug them or anything because of the precautions that we're taking during the global pandemic. But you know what? You can still see them via video. You can still talk to them on the phone. And here's another thing. You don't always have to be on video with people. Remember when we made phone calls where we just heard, you know, talk to people, just the audio? There are a whole lot of things that you have to do differently when you are having a phone conversation with someone versus a video chat. In the video, we get lazy. We look at, you know, cues, you know, visual cues of their body language and you know, and their demeanor and their expressions. We use that to get all our information and draw conclusions and make determinations about what they think or they feel. But when you're just speaking to someone over the phone, you have to really listen, really connect, really tune in to what they're saying and how they're saying it. You can't half listen because you're watching their thing and because of the expression on their face, you kind of pick up some stuff that you may have missed in the conversation. No, you really have to listen. Podcasts are another reason, another way you have to listen. You're not watching me. You can't see the gestures that I make. You can't see the passion that I'm speaking with. You can't see my expressions. You can't see the funny little faces that I make. You can't see any of that. But you can hear it. You can sense it. And if you open yourself up enough to move beyond just the words that I'm saying and really connect with what does this mean to me? How does this impact me? What does this mean for the things that I want to do? What do I feel about it? What does this mean about the things I've always believed? What is this? How does this impact my actions? How does this impact the way I treat others? How does this impact what I'm going to do next in my meetings or with my teams or how I'm going to lead my organization? How does this make an impact on me? How does this change what I'm going to do and how I'm going to do it? Let's skip the content. Let's stop treating all of this as if it is information to be consumed. And instead, let's start connecting with the information, really delving into it, connecting with other people, having great conversations about it, and connecting with ourselves and determining how we're going to use this to become better. I hope this has been helpful. Please reach out to me on my website at carsgroup.com. That's carsgroup.com. Leave me a message. Let me know how this is. Comment on my YouTube channel or wherever you're listening to this and let me know what you think. Let's connect. I'm Keisha A. Rivers, President and Chief Outcome Facilitator of the Cars Group, where we facilitate outcomes by equipping people to embrace and manage change. You've been listening to Mindset to Mastery, the podcast where we give you tools, tips, and actionable items to assist you in changing your mindset and mastering your success. As always, stay safe, stay sane, and stay sanitized. Bye-bye.